Hey, and welcome to Need to Make It, I'm Mike. We just finished a video showing how to add linear rails to your Ender 3 version 3 model KE printer, and it turned out pretty nice, and now after a few prints, they run nice and smooth as well. Now when designing this, I had a lot of trouble finding a place to secure the adapter plates to the printer properly. That's because this printer really is not designed to let us modify it very easily. So in this video, we're going to change all that by modularizing this printer. So stick around. Before we get into it, consider subscribing to the channel and hitting the notification bell as well so you always know when a new video is released. And I also try and respond to every comment, so leaving a note, no matter how small, is always appreciated, and it definitely helps with that YouTube algorithm. In the previous video, we finished with the linear rails and we were testing out a polycarbonate plate that goes below the aluminum heat bed. And unfortunately, I couldn't quite finish that project because there were some small clearance problems, but I've now been able to get it to work and I've run a few prints on it and it seems to work pretty well. This reduces the mass of the bed by about 350 grams. And I know it doesn't seem like much, but it is when we're constantly changing direction at high speed. And that's all great, and we will continue to work on that project, but for now we need to focus on some other areas like stabilizing the posts so we have less vibration on the Z axis. And that's unfortunately where we have some problems. We don't have any attachment points. I could use double-sided mounting tape, but it's not easy to remove and it's a little bit gimmicky. So what else can we do? Well, this is an injection molded ABS plastic base, which means adding some attachment points is actually pretty easy. My KE is flipped upside down, and I found that a little bit easier just to remove the post so I can have really good access to this. You don't need to do what I'm doing here. I'm gonna remove the bottom panel. Before we go any further, you can see that I have this unplugged. Please make sure if you're gonna do this that the printer is not plugged in. It's a good idea to take the power cord right off of it as well. So if we have a look here, we have these threaded inserts that we've just removed the bottom panel from. And going even further down, we can see it's reinforced right through to the top of the base plate. So now what we can do is take these six holes, and obviously you can just decide if you want to do all six or if you can just do the two at the back. Depends on what it is that you're trying to upgrade. So I have a 2.5 millimeter diameter drill bit. You can put that through. I'm gonna stop right here for a second because I can hear some of you yelling at me, don't drill through the plastic, you're making it look ugly, you're weakening it, and I don't like your drill. So here's the deal. This is an inexpensive printer, and to get the most out of these printers, we need to upgrade them to do that. And we're gonna need some mounting points. So I'm just doing what Creality should have given us in the first place, and I'm gonna try and make it as pretty as possible. So with this change, we have six additional holes, which is pretty good, but it's not really good enough. I think that we should have a lot more connections. So what I've done is I've created all of these reinforcement pieces. They're kind of like puzzle pieces and they only fit in one spot. Well, this one actually fits in two if you flip it over, but you get the point. So we're gonna start here and work our way around. So before we can get these in place, I need to remove the screws for the board. And I need to remove the two screws here for the plug in for the power. All right, so if you're not good with puzzles, each of these are numbered and we're gonna work our way right around. And these are made from ABS, so it is the same material as what this base is made from. This is only 3 millimeters thick, and I didn't think that just putting a heatset insert into a 3 millimeter base was gonna be good enough. So these are an additional 8 millimeters thick. On top of that, I thought I would experiment a little bit. These are 10 millimeters by M3. Normally I only use 6 millimeters or less, but I wanted to try these out just to see how they work. So 10 millimeters, it's probably a little bit overkill, nearly 5.7. And the 10 millimeter, it's probably a little less than 10. Oh, very close to 10. So there are quite a few different ways of getting this in there and making sure that it stays in place. So these are going to be inserted from this side, and we're also going to drill from this side as well. So what I'm going to use is this ABS slurry that I've had hanging around, but you could probably use super glue. You could probably even use hot glue as well. So the beauty of this setup is that you can do all or one or two or however many you want. In fact, you can put these reinforcement pieces in and you don't even need to drill them out if you don't want to. You can just use them later on. I'm gonna go ahead and do all of them because that's the point of this video and I wanna show you what it's all going to look like as well. But I think this is gonna work really well, especially with these 10 millimeter long heatset inserts. And talking about heatset inserts, I've ordered heatset inserts from AliExpress and I'm still waiting for them. They were supposed to be here for the last video and they're not. These were ordered from Amazon and they showed up the next day. So yes, I had to pay a little bit more for these, but I can go ahead and finish the project. Now I can grab a 4 millimeter drill bit. I'm going to let this acetone slurry set for a little bit before I go ahead and try and drill these holes, because if I don't, these are probably just going to pull up on me. All right, just to make sure that I keep this out of the way of any drilling, I've just used some electrical tape. So this says 6B, it's gonna go right in here on top of 6A. And if you'll notice, it's slightly inset from the top, and that's on purpose because of the metal plate that goes on here. It's set down slightly. So if you flip this around, and I've already adjusted the template so it locks in a bit better, we get our positioning for drilling from this side. Don't recommend drilling all the way through if your finger's on the back. Now, since we're having to go in from the outside and this is going to melt the plastic a little bit, I'm going to just deburr the edge just a tiny little bit. With all of that done, I'm going to flip this back over and make sure that I put everything back into place, including the zip ties that I took off. I'm just going to do a little bit of a cleanup because my skill with putting in inserts is maybe not the best. That is cleaned up, and you know what? It doesn't look too bad. I wouldn't say I did a perfect job, but with a little bit more practice, I probably could have done a little bit better. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. We have 20 possible mounting points to this printer now. Now I'm not suggesting that you do all of these like what I did, but you might just do, for example, the back holes, because I have a project that's coming up that is going to need to use those. I think this looks really good, and now we have a whole bunch more possibilities for connections. My only caution with this approach is that we have some holes that have something below them, so it is best to avoid anything deeper than 10 millimeters to prevent any issues. And I would tend to make that a rule for all of the holes just to be safe. And I think if Creality could make a base like this with the connection points already built in, I think it would be a great way to set their product apart from everyone else's. All that's left to do now is connect something, and I have just the thing. Thanks as always to each of my patrons for helping to support this channel and making videos like this possible. And anyone on our Patreon is welcome to join our Discord server as well for live chats and sharing of all of our ideas and progress as well. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Take care, and we will see you on the next one.